Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and configure the React dialog component in it. Using the dialog component, you can create a dialog box to collect input from users, warn them about errors, or confirm their decisions. In this video, I will show you how to add a dialog component to the React app and configure a few of its features, like adding header and footer to the dialog, dragging, resizing, positioning, and animation. Let me start with the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. I want to create the React app with TypeScript, so I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the dialog component, I will type the command npm install /ej2react-popups-save. Let's wait for the package to install. Before using a SyncFusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register trial license method from the SyncFusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To see where to generate trial license key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. After that, I import the React dialog component from the SyncFusion EJ2 React popups package. And I include the dialog component tag and set the height and width properties with appropriate values. I open the app.css file and replace the default styles with the necessary SyncFusion material CSS reference for the dialog component. I define a few CSS styles, display, height, margin, overflow, width, for the HTML and body element. Now, let's proceed to run the application using the command npm start. The React dialog is rendered without any header and content. Now, I will show you how to add content and a header to the dialog component. To do that, I am going to add the content and header properties inside the dialog component tag. I add header property with the value dialog and the content property with the value this is a dialog with content. Here you can see the dialog displayed with the header and content. Next, I will show you how to add a button to the footer of the dialog. I define an object called buttons and add the button model property. Within this property, I set the content as cancel. Then, I assign this object to the buttons property of the dialog component. See now, the dialog is displayed with the cancel button. But the dialog does not close after clicking the cancel button. So, I need to write the code to close the dialog when I click the cancel button. I define the variables visibility and set dialog visibility. Set the initial value of the set dialog visibility as true using useState hook. To access the useState hook, I need to import it from React. I add the click property in the buttons object to change the dialog visibility when I click the cancel button. And set the set dialog visibility value as false. It will change the dialog visibility when I click the cancel button. I add the visible property and assign this variable to it. The dialog will close when I click the cancel button now. If I want to close the dialog using the close icon, I need to use the show close icon property and set its value to true. In the dialog, you can see the close icon. When I click, the dialog is closed. Alright, now I want to show the dialog again after I close. So, I use the button element and set the button text as open dialog. Then, I set the class name as eControl and eButton. As you know, I am going to open this dialog again while clicking the button, so let me add onClickEvent with the event handler handleClick. After that, I define a handleClick method and set dialog visibility value to true. It will open the dialog when the button is clicked. In app.css file, I define padding top and left with appropriate values for the class app. See now, after I close the dialog, I can open it again by clicking the Open Dialog button. By default, the dialog is displayed in the center of the page. To change this position, I need to define a variable position of type position data model. To access the position data model, I need to import it from SyncFusion EJ to React Popups package. For the X property, I can set the value to left, center, right, or any offset value. For the Y property, I can set the value to top, center, bottom, or any offset value. I want to render the dialog at the bottom left. So, I set the X property value to left and Y property value to bottom. I assign this variable position to the position property. The dialog is displayed in the bottom left of the page. Next, I will show you how to drag and resize the dialog. To drag the dialog, I use the allow dragging property and set its value to true. To resize the dialog, I use the enable resize property and set its value to true. Look, I can drag and resize the dialog now. You will notice that you can resize the dialog from the bottom right position only. Suppose I want to resize in all directions. I use the resize handles property and set the value as wall. See, you can resize the dialog in all directions. Finally, I am going to explain how to animate the dialog component. For that, I define a variable animation of type any with the effect property. Here, I set the value as flipX for this property. I want to show the dialog in center, so I change the position, X and Y values to center. Finally, I assign the animation variable in the animation settings property. Look, the dialog will display with the flipX up effect. Notice that I can interact with the output page when the dialog is open. To restrict this interaction, I use the isModel property and set its value to true. Now, the interaction with the output page is restricted. In this video, I have shown you how to add a dialog component to a React application and import a few of its features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.